Hey everyone, it's Lena here, and in this short video, I'm excited to show you how to make music with Logic and KeyLab Essential. Let's dive in. Logic comes with a dedicated KeyLab Essential MIDI script, which allows KeyLab Essential to be recognized instantly after launching it alongside your DAW. However, it's always good to make sure you're using the latest DAW versions to ensure the best KeyLab Essential integration experience. Normally, with the latest DAW version, you won't need to dive deep into the menu to set it up, as it's done automatically when you launch your DAW. Let's begin with the main encoder. The main encoder is used to navigate through the tracks in Logic. Simply turn the encoder to move between tracks. Clicking the main encoder will show or close the selected plugin, allowing you to access its parameters. Next, we have knobs 1 to 8 and faders 1 to 8. In device mode, these knobs control various parameters of the currently focused plugin. Simply turn the knobs to adjust the parameter values. This will allow you to shape your sound while playing with your instruments. Additionally, in mixer mode, these knobs and faders control the volume and panning of the corresponding track. Use the knobs to adjust the parameters and slide the faders to control the volume and panning. Knob 9 and fader 9 have dedicated functions. They control both the volume and panning of the selected track. You can use knob 9 to adjust the panning position and fader 9 to control the volume level of the selected track. Now let's explore the contextual buttons. Contextual button number 1 toggles between device and mixer control modes. Use this button to switch between controlling the devices and the mixer in Logic. Contextual button number 3 is used to mute the selected track, while contextual button number 4 is used to solo the selected track. Moving on to the transport section, we have the play, stop, record, and loop buttons. These buttons are self-explanatory and allow you to control the playback and recording of your music. Now let's move on to the pads. Pressing the pads will trigger sounds in Logic. This means that pads will send MIDI notes and trigger the sounds coming from melodic or drum instruments assigned to your track. This will be great for finger drumming your rhythms. If you're using Analog Lab, it's important to ensure that the correct device is linked when you open the plugin. To have full control over Analog Lab, you can enter Analog Lab mode by selecting the Arturia program using the Prog button. When Analog Lab is selected, you can manage the plugin just like you would in standalone mode, including navigation, selection, and applying effects. Okay, that's it. Hopefully this video demonstrates how quick, easy, and fun it is to use KeyLab Essential with Logic. For more detailed information on KeyLab Essential and how to use it, make sure to watch the rest of our how-to videos on our channel. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.